The film Vampire Academy is obviously set in St. Vladimir's Academy, which is a school designed to teach young vampire, a young Maroi and young Dampir from all over the world how to use their powers and adapt to their strengths, train for the threats that are outside the world. But at the same time, the movie covers a lot of our history and a lot of our kind of mythology as vampires and as Maroi and Dampir, and then leads into a kind of a struggle between good and evil, and the tragedy and all of the things that go on. So there's kind of, the academy is where we would set our scene. Mm.
I guess you need to set the context.
Yeah.
Because the story exists particular to this world, and in this world there's the Maroi vampires, mm-hmm. who at the academy are learning how to use their powers, and they feed off blood. And then there's the half human, half vampires, the Dampir, who at the academy are learning how to protect the Maroi from the Strigoi, which are the undead evil vampires, which the academy keeps out with magic force fields and lots of protection.
So Christian's very lonely, very isolated. As Lucy mentioned, the Strigoi, the kind of the evil undead vampires. That's what Christian's parents turned themselves into, and they actually tried to turn Christian into that as well when he was very young. So he's gone through his school life being very lonely and very isolated, which is actually what draws Lissa and Christian together, is their kind of loneliness and their isolation, their feeling that they can't talk to anyone and they can't express their feelings with anyone who truly understands. Then we finally kind of find each other, and
Yeah, when Lissa is brought back to the academy after running away from the darkness that she feels there and her pain from losing her family, she is on the outside, and when she sees Christian and sees someone who's going through the same things as her, it's this instant connection of understanding, which is also juxtaposed by the tension from the fact that he is really on the outside of the school, and whether she wants to let herself go into something that's really dark, which is...
And potentially dangerous as well, because this is how much of a threat the Strigoi are, that it literally is the worst thing that you can do, and they are the biggest threat in our world. So as well as being isolated and degraded through school, he is seen as a threat. He's seen as dangerous. So obviously Lissa has to kind of battle with that in her own head of whether she wants to get close to
be with
to
someone
us.
Who could potentially turn Strigoi.
Yeah.
I guess for our characters, the feeling of being on the outside is something that teenagers always go through. And that's something that they deal with by being together. Mm-hmm. They can kind of learn how to be comfortable in themselves so that they're okay being on the outside. But of course, you have to go through a crazy journey in order to get there. And for Lissa, having the friendship with Rose, that's something that all teenagers will be able to relate to, the importance of friendship and to really be there for each other no matter what happens, no matter how crazy someone gets off powers in this instance, and the need to protect Rose and the sort of insanity almost that comes from that, being there for each other amidst everything. And the same with Christian. He's there for Lissa even after she goes on this crazy journey, which is, it's really nice for Lissa to have the two people who really care about her.
Yeah, absolutely. And it was, I mean, as you say, we do have, what's interesting about it is, and we've mentioned it a couple of times before, it's not someone new coming to explore our world. We know that we're vampires. We were born vampires. This is all we've ever known. This is what we've grown up with. So the school to us is the same as any other school that you or I would go to. It's exactly the same. So obviously, naturally, we develop kind of the bully and then the outcast and the princess, and like we've got a mean headmistress and like the teacher that everyone has a crush on. Like we have all of that sort of stuff because we are in a weird way, we're normal teenagers because we're so used to the surreal life that we lead. So all of the Maroi are supposed to specialize in an elemental magic. So either fire, wind, earth, or water? Did I say water?
Yeah,
fire, yeah. So Christian specializes in fire. He's a fire magic user, which is so cool.
Yeah.
It's so much fun. Like, it's really awesome.
If I didn't have spirit, I think fire would be...
That would be the one.
Yeah.
Right, yeah. And then, there are the occasional exceptions, where they don't specialize in one.
It only happens once every few centuries. Mm-hmm. Which is very rare.
Very rare.
I guess from the very beginning of reading a script written by Daniel Waters, which is the writer of Heathers, it's so funny and offbeat and quirky in this mysterious dark world where anything can happen. You kind of go into this place where craziness is just normal. And then to have the director, Mark Waters, of Mean Girls, to bring out all this humor, instantly you're in an environment where it's just going to be playful. And then add on top of that a cast who are amazing people, really fun. We just genuinely connected straight away and have this really playful energy amongst everyone. You couldn't really go wrong.
No, I think it's important to note as well that the crew were in, because I don't know how, like, no one really seemed to kind of put this in their head properly when we first started working, but obviously halfway through we switched to night shoots. So we would get there at kind of 5 and wouldn't leave till 2, 3, 4 in the morning, but no one had really realized until someone said, right, next week we're going to night shoots, and everyone went, oh yeah, that's right, yeah, we're gonna have to do night shoots. But everyone was totally cool with it. Like, there was no, like, darkness or animosity. It was really great, and that obviously
no darkness.
Yeah, because it was at night. But it was really nice that the cast and the crew and obviously Mark and Dan and everyone, we were all very light with each other. There weren't I didn't have a day where
entered into this dark world together and went into vampire land and would stay asleep all day and then come out at night in this weird sort of vampire family.
Yeah,
the crew were amazing in that they kind of were really fun, and we would just have to make so many jokes because we'd all be so tired and delirious that we would just kind of...
We all ended up kind of bouncing off each other.
Yeah.